Welcome to the first of four short tutorials on how to use truth tables. In this tutorial, we will define the four logical operators of OR, AND, IF THEN, which in logic is called material implication, and NOT, which we've already talked about and is called the tilde. OR is represented by a symbol that looks like this, which is called the wedge. AND is represented with this, which is called the dot. Material implication, which very loosely corresponds to English if then, is represented by a symbol that looks like this and is called the horseshoe. NOT is represented by the tilde. The first step is to define the four logically possible combinations of true and false. So if you have two propositions, A and B, there's four and only four ways they can be related. Both can be true, A can be true, B false, B, A can be false, and B can be true, or both A and B can be false. Once we have the four possible ways that true and false can be defined, then we can stipulate what we mean by the wedge, A or B. Well, what we mean, what a logician means by wedge, is that if one or the other or both are true, then the whole thing is true. So if you have both true here, then the whole thing is true. If one's true and the other one is false, then it's true. This one false, this one true, then true. Only when they are both false is the whole thing false. That's what the wedge means logically. The stipulative definition for dot, which roughly, well, in this case, closely corresponds to the English word and, is simply that for A dot B to be true, both A and B have to be true. In all other cases, true, false, false, true, false, false, the whole thing is going to be false. The horseshoe, which is called material implication, is defined like this. And here, as I explain in the text, the correspondence to the English words if then is, well, very loose to say the least. But again, the point of truth tables is to rigorously define certain logical operators, and this is how you make computers. That's what truth tables are all about. How do you program a computer? So the horseshoe is defined when A and B are both true, the whole thing is true. Only when A is true, A, which comes first, is called the antecedent, and B, which comes second, is called the consequent. Only when the antecedent is true and the consequent is false is the whole thing false. If the antecedent is false and the consequent is true, the whole thing is defined as true. And again, we're doing this just so that we can make our computer work. And if both of the antecedent and the consequent are false, the whole thing is still true. Again, we need to fill out all four rows if we're going to eliminate all ambiguity. And only if the ambiguity is all gone will our computers work. The final is simply the tilde, and that simply means not. And so if A is true, not A is false, and if A is false, then not A is true. Those are the definitions, the logically rigorous definitions of our four logical operators. The wedge, the dot, the horseshoe, and the tilde. Thanks for listening. Bye.